slipping out with the sparkling diamonds of Spain in my mouth.
The alarm and is rhyming and he comes running, jumps right in.
Hey, where are you going?
Well, I'm in a hurry.
Why is
where to first he a day?
Oh, a bad
where's mouth? Oh.
What are you doing in the
it's my web.
Hey, get it off you. You're a careless your own web.
I it so a slippery snake. Yes, but he's gone. He was dressed lady.
I must have so that's why small
didn't hang on.
I know where he went. He had a
was no
this looked very
that was the spark was in slippery
it is stolen finished punk current
oh well, Mr. Worry
why
was I am to capture and the spark plan is let me hear you say
fellow comrades, National Socialists. This is Lincoln Rockwell at the national headquarters of the American Nazi Party in Arlington, Virginia. That I could be there with you, dear racial comrades, as you meet from our Nordic countries all over the globe in Britain today. But as many of you know, it has been impossible for me to travel to most of the so-called democratic nations because of the fact that I have been banned by these nations, even though they permit communists freely to pass their borders and run around within their countries, spreading the poison of Marxism and communism. In fact, I understand that the Prime Minister of Australia got the immigration minister out of the bathtub in the middle of the night to hysterically order that I be banned from Australia. In fact, about a month ago, when the Nationalist Australian Workers' Party invited me to address their rally. Because of the genius of our Nordic ancestors and the Germanic peoples and the Anglo-Saxon peoples, we have the miracle of electronics, and through this medium, I can address you as directly as possible, short of being there in person. It is very difficult, of course, to address my remarks to such a general group of people I do not know, and the composition of which meeting I do not know. I am sure that many of my friends are there, but there may also be people there that you may not wish to play such a case before, with remarks that might constitute, shall we say, too strong. Therefore, I shall endeavor to keep my remarks somewhat general and certainly somewhat safe. From my point of view here, I want to congratulate first the British National Party, Colin Jordan, and all of the men who are making the meeting there possible, the men who have been so courageously battling the forces which have taken over Britain, perhaps much more even than the United States, and who are, I am sure, there today. My very long gentlemen, to take your hand personally and stand beside you as you fight there in Britain. And I hope someday you will be able to watch that deer defying the tyrants as they attempt to take over our country. I am sure there are representatives there also from Sweden, and to these men, I extend our warmth to you. Men in Sweden, like the men in Britain, are putting up a magnificent battle, fight of terrible odds, and we wish them all the luck and success in the world. We'll do all we can to help them at any time. And of course, that goes for all of you from the other countries, the other areas of the world. Our hearts belong to National Socialism, to the Aryan white man, far more than they belong to any national boundary or any artificial creations of man.
in the meantime, I have decided I should go back.
Back to dream.
Thank you. Thank you. Mother! Oh, God! Mother! Blood! Blood!
Give you some example of the sort of thing that we face here over. I try my best to rise above it, and I shall do so on this tape. The first thing that I think most of our comrades from the other countries will want to know is how the party, how the American National Party, is progressing. And gentlemen and ladies, I am most happy to inform you that we are making progress, which is beyond my fondest dream of a year ago. I am speaking to you from a new place we have just attained for our growing storm group. We had as many as 7 and 8 men sleeping on the floors and on cushions and on chairs in each room of the headquarters as more and more people poured into it. And now we have attained a beautiful 17-room with 3 baths mansion, an old southern mansion on a hill, in 18 wooded acres of beautiful estate. And the place is secure and safe from the attacks that we used to get. We have posted guards, of course, and this is more or less now like an army post. We are comfortable. There are 3 baths here. We have hot water for the first time. We have all the fire group at one time, and we are looking at material at the headquarters is prefaced by the word hate. We have hate spoons and hate knives, hate dinners, and as you may have noticed in the bulletin, although I question the propriety of it somewhat, I think that the propaganda value will outweigh the possible impropriety. We are now also supplied with hate toilet paper with 6-pointed stars on each sheet, and also with pictures of some of the more notorious Jewish criminals.
Another fine mess they got themselves into. Norwich is always doing good.
Coming up next,
what a what are we gonna step?
For most common stuff discovers, the one that copes is the only one you need.
Thank you.